Hi, I'm Michael Kirkbride, and I'm here in the East Village talking about my first novel, A Deep Scratch in the Vinyl. I'm going to walk around the neighborhood, look at some of the spots that feature prominently in the book and some of my favorite spots in the neighborhood, and talk about the book as well. I hope you enjoy it. So we're in Sophie's on 5th Street in the East Village, one of my favorite bars. So Deep Scratch in the Vinyl is a story about two guys, two best friends who grew up together, spent a lot of time down the Lower East Side going to CBGBs on the weekends, and best friends. They moved out to Los Angeles together, did Teach for America together, taught in Compton, lived in L.A., lived by the beach, lived through the riots in L.A., moved back to New York together, lived together here in New York. Third character in the story is a woman who comes along. Both of the guys fall in love with her. She falls in love with one of them. So it's a pretty basic love triangle. The story is meant to evoke the feeling of the East Village in the early 90s, and the music and the bars, and this is where Sophie's on 5th Street right now, which is one of the places that they and people like them hung out. We're in front of Ace Bar on 5th Street between A and B. Another great bar. I'd take you inside, except I was banned for life for fighting back in 1995, and I cannot go inside. So we're down at the corner of Bleecker and Bowery, and across the street from what used to be CBGB. And CBGB is where the two main guy characters in the book became best friends. They'd sneak out of their apartments on Sunday afternoon and come down here for the hardcore matinee and see Sick of It All and Ag Front and Agnostic Front, all these great bands from back then. And that's where they truly realized that they were best friends and started their lifelong bond together, is right down here. The neighborhood's changed a lot. This was 25 years ago. CBGB's no longer there. Still see people walking around with the Agnostic Front t-shirts though. And this is where they became best friends down here. We're here on 7th Street now, in front of Big Bar, the ironically named Big Bar, because it's actually really small. This is a bar, great bar, great neighborhood bar, very special to me because it's where my wife asked me out for the first time. Excellent bar, recommend stopping by here as well. Holiday Cocktail Lounge, one of the best dive bars in the world. Open unpredictable, odd hours. If you're in the neighborhood and it's open, definitely stop in here for a drink. So we're here down in the East Village on 1st Avenue. This is the neighborhood where I lived in most of the 90s and where the characters in the book all lived through the 90s. I lived here in this building. Studio apartment, two closets. One was a shower, one was a toilet. Sitting over three Indian restaurants, one of which the Royal Indian downstairs we frequented. Guaranteed to keep you stuffed for about a week after eating there. Tar Beach upstairs, spend afternoons and the weekend upstairs getting some sun. This part of the neighborhood hasn't changed that much, actually. Rents have gone up, certainly, but buildings are all still the same. Shops are pretty much still the same. That Indian restaurants, these have been here for decades. So this neighborhood hasn't changed much at all, really. We're at 7B, at the corner of 7th and B in the East Village. My favorite bar, the best jukebox in New York. Never terribly crowded, never terribly empty. Just a perfect neighborhood bar. At the opening of the book, Scott and Larry are sitting at the bar. I envision them sitting right here behind us. And Larry gets up to go to the bathroom, and Sonia is sitting next to Scott and whispers to him, "Save me," because some guy is trying to hit on her. They haven't met before, and Scott and Sonia start talking, and Scott immediately feels that Sonia might be someone special, and Larry comes back, swoops in, steals her away, and the two of them fall in love and sets the action of the story in motion. The East Village in the early 90s was, for me anyway, the perfect place to live. And every night, you just sort of hit the streets and you escape from your little tiny apartment and find people to go out with and listen to great music and have a few beers. The story looks back to a moment in time, which was a great moment in time, but it's really just about boys and girls in America who were in their 20s meeting each other and having a few drinks and going out to see rock and roll. It could have been any city. It just happened to be here in the East Village in the early 90s, which I think was a special moment, but it could have been anywhere. And the kids could have been anywhere. And so, yeah, I think the book's for anyone. So this is one time I came in here and got really drunk, and then did it again the next night, and then the next night, for like 10 years.
That's the story.
Did my wife text you again?